Dear students, in this video lecture, we will derive EMF equation of an alternator. In construction, we have seen that an alternator consists of main parts like stator and rotor. On the stator inner periphery, slots are cut, and in those slots three phase windings are placed. These windings are called armature winding also, and the conductors inside the slots are called as armature conductors. The total number of armature conductors are divided into three equal parts, and using each part, a phase winding is formed. So I'll write here now. Let Z be the number of conductors per phase. In armature winding, F be the frequency of EMF induced in armature winding. If T is the number of turns per phase, then T is equal to Z by 2. It is so because in one turn there are two conductors. So this is conductor one, this is conductor two. So number of conductors is two and turn is one. So we can write T is equal to Z by 2. NBD speed of rotor. But we know that alternator operates at synchronous speed, therefore N is equal to 120 F upon P. Where P is number of poles for which armature is wound. Also, we must know that armature poles number equals rotor poles number. By Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, average EMF induced in a conductor E is equal to change in flux in one rotation of rotor by the time required to complete one rotation. So how much is the change in flux in one rotation of rotor that links with a conductor is here now. Looking at this figure, when the rotor moves in clockwise direction, then in one complete rotation, all the poles on the rotor will pass through the conductor. Therefore, all the flux produced by rotor poles will be linking with the armature conductors. Therefore, change in flux in one complete rotation is equal to number of poles into flux per pole. So here we can write now P phi, it is change in flux in one rotation of rotor, by Time required to complete one rotation. Knowing the speed, n is equal to 120 f upon p, we can calculate the time required to complete one rotation as 60 by n. Simplifying, we get P phi n by 60. But n is equal to 120 F. Upon P. Therefore, average EMF induced in a conductor is P into 5 divided by 60 into 120 F upon P. Simplifying, we get two times phi f since there are z number of conductors. In each phase winding, of armature, average EMF induced in phase winding EPH is equal to 2 into 5 into F into Z. For one conductor, EMF induced is 2 phi f. Therefore, for z number of conductors, EMF induced is 2 phi f z. Since t is equal to 2, we can write 2 times t is equal to z. Therefore, EPH becomes 2 into 5 into f into 2t, and that is 4 phi f t. RMS value of EMF induced per phase EPH is equal to form factor into average EMF, which is 4 pi FT. Hence, 4.44 pi FT is RMS EMF induced in each phase winding. We have to include the pitch factor and the winding factor with winding factors KC and KD or KP and KW. EPH becomes 4.44 pi FT KC KD.